Welcome to a lesson on determining the angle between two vectors. The angle between two vectors u and v can be defined by cosine theta is equal to u dotted with v divided by the magnitude of u times the magnitude of v. We will prove this formula in a different video. This video will just provide examples of determining theta. We should remember though that the vectors are parallel if u and v are scalar multiples of one another, and that if u dotted with v is equal to 0, the two vectors are orthogonal or perpendicular. Let's go and take a look at our examples. So from our formula, cosine theta, this ratio here, so the numerator is u dotted with v, so we'll have 3 times negative 2 plus 4 times 3 plus 7 times negative 5. Our denominator is going to be the magnitude of u times the magnitude of v. So we're going to have the square root of 3 squared, that's 9, plus 4 squared, that's 16, plus 7 squared, that's 49, times the square root of negative 2 squared, that's positive 4, plus 3 squared is 9, plus negative 5 squared is positive 25. Let's go ahead and simplify this. So the numerator is going to be negative 29. Here we'll have the square root of 74. And here we'll have the square root of 38. So if cosine theta is equal to this ratio, remember that tells us that theta would be equal to inverse cosine of this ratio. Now from here, we'll go to our calculator to determine theta. Let's make sure that we're in degree mode. Press mode, notice that degree is highlighted. Now we're going to press second cosine, which brings up inverse cosine, and then we'll type in our ratio. So negative 29 is our numerator. Our denominator is the square root of 74 times the square root of 38. Press enter. So theta is approximately 123.2 degrees. Now let's go and take a look at these two vectors in space to see if this angle seems reasonable. So here we see the two vectors in space. If we angle this correctly, you can see that that angle between those two vectors is definitely an obtuse angle, and an angle of 123 degrees looks about right. Let's go and take a look at a couple other examples. Same question, two different vectors. So we'll go ahead and set up our formula for cosine theta. The numerator is going to be the dot product, so we'll have 3 times negative 3 plus 2 times 7 plus negative 1 times 5. Numerator is going to be the magnitude of u times the magnitude of v. So here we're going to have 3 squared, that's 9, plus 2 squared, that's 4, plus negative 1 squared is 1, times the square root of negative 3 squared, that's 9, plus 49, plus 25. Let's go ahead and simplify this. Negative 9 plus 14 plus negative 5, that's actually 0. And our denominator is going to be the square root of 14 times the square root of 83. But we don't have to go any further, because if the dot product is equal to 0, as we see here, we know that these two vectors are going to be orthogonal or perpendicular, so theta is going to be equal to 90 degrees, or pi over 2 radians. Again, we could continue. Theta is equal to inverse cosine of 0, which again will give us 90 degrees. Again, let's go ahead and take a look at this one graphically as well. So here are the two vectors. If we angle this correctly, we can see that it does appear to be a 90 degree angle between these two vectors. Let's go ahead and take a look at one more example. So again, we have cosine theta is equal to this fraction where the numerator is the dot product. So we have 2 times negative 1 plus 4 times negative 2 plus 6 times negative 3 all over the magnitude of u, which is going to be 2 squared, that's 4, plus 4 squared is 16, plus 6 squared would be 36, times the square root of negative 1 squared, that's 1, plus negative 2 squared, that's 4, plus negative 3 squared is 9. Let's go ahead and simplify this. Looks like we have negative 28. Our denominator is going to be the square root of 56 times the square root of 14. Now for this example, I'm going to go ahead and determine the product of these two square roots on the calculator. We have the square root of 56 times the square root of 14. What we're going to notice is it comes out to 28. So this ratio is negative 28 over positive 28, which is equal to negative 1. So theta is equal to inverse cosine of negative 1, which we should be familiar with. That's going to be 180 degrees. So what's happening here is, if we go back to the original problem, these are actually scalar multiples of one another. If we take vector u and multiply it by negative 1/2, it will equal vector v. And remember, if two vectors are scalar multiples of one another, they are actually parallel vectors. So these vectors are parallel. But since the angle between them is 180 degrees, they are going to be pointing in the opposite direction. Let's go and take a look at this graphically. So again, here we see the purple vector and the red vector, and they're pointing in the opposite direction, but they are scalar multiples of one another, and therefore they are parallel vectors. Okay, that's going to do it for this video. I hope you found these examples helpful. Have a good day.